Naval Group,
formerly known as DCNS,
is a French industrial group specialized in naval defense and marine renewable energy. The group employs next to 13,000 people in 18 countries. Naval Group, a private law company in which the French state holds a 62.49% stake, Thales 35% and the personnel a 1.64% stake and the company itself 0.87%, is the heir to the French naval dockyards and the Direction des Constructions et Armes Navales (DECAN), which became the DCN (Direction des Constructions Navales) in 1991, DCNS in 2007 and Naval Group since 2017.
History.
Naval Group has a heritage almost 400 years. Major shipyards were built in France in Brest 1631, Nantes-Indre 1771, Lorient 1778 and, subsequently, in Cherbourg 1813. Others were to follow. As early as 1926, what we know as Naval Group today already had all the facilities now owned by the group in mainland France.
The birth of the naval dockyards.
In 1624, Cardinal Richelieu, who was Louis XIII of France's prime minister at the time, devised a naval policy that provided for the development of the dockyards in order to give France sufficient maritime power to rival that of England. This policy was implemented from 1631, with the creation of the Ponant Fleet in the Atlantic and the Levant Fleet in the Mediterranean, the Brest dockyards and the extension of the Toulon dockyards, created under Henri IV. The policy was continued by Colbert, Louis XIV's Navy Minister, who developed several major dockyards. He extended the dockyards in Toulon, ordered the excavation of the docks in Brest and founded the Rochefort dockyards. His son, Seignelay, who succeeded him in 1683, followed in his footsteps. The French Royal Navy's network of dockyards was further strengthened in the 18th century. In 1750, the Marquis de Montalembert converted a former paper mill into a forge producing cannons at Rueil-sur-Touve. In 1777, Antoine de Sartine, Louis XVI's Navy Minister, opened a cannon foundry near the naval shipyards in Indre. In the same year, work started on the development of the port in Cherbourg, which was completed in 1813. In 1778, the Lorient Naval Dockyards succeeded La Compagnie des Indes du Port de l'Orient. The naval dockyards in Rochefort were closed in 1926. In 1937, the establishment in Saint-Tropez was opened on the former site of the company Schneider, which specialized in torpedoes. By this time, most of the Naval Group's French sites already existed, and they have not changed since then.
Industrialization and technical innovations.
During the 19th century, the naval dockyards underwent a transformation as the fleet of sailing ships was replaced by motorized vessels. The sites were industrialized and gradually specialized. In 1865, the naval dockyards in Brest became exclusively military, with the closure of the Penfeld port to commercial vessels. In 1898, after specializing in the building of vessels with propellers rather than sails, the shipyards in Cherbourg were tasked exclusively with the construction of submarines. Finally, in 1927, a decree definitively laid out the missions of the various naval dockyards. Brest and Lorient were tasked with the construction of large vessels, Cherbourg with building submarines, while Toulon, Bizerte and Saigon took charge of the maintenance of the fleet. This rationalization of the roles of the naval dockyards was accompanied by technical and military innovations and the production of vessels at a higher pace, against the backdrop of an arms race and colonization. In 1858, Glory, the first ocean-going battleship in the world, sailed out of the dockyards in Toulon. The 1860s saw the arrival of the first torpedo boats and military submarines, with the launch of Plongeor in 1863. The technical problems experienced by this first ever motorized submarine meant that it remained a prototype rather than an operational war vessel. But it did open the way for the construction of Gymnote in 1886 and Le Narval in 1899, which were the first operational torpedo submarines in history. The production of heavy surface vessels was also stepped up in the 1910s. Several battleships were built before the start of the First World War, and the fleet was strengthened by the 35,000-ton Richelieu in 1939. Reorganization of activities. In 1946, a review of the French naval dockyards completed the attributions of the various sites announced in the 1927 decree. Brest was tasked with the production and repair of large vessels, Lorient with the construction of medium-sized vessels, Cherbourg with submarines and Toulon with repairing and maintaining the fleet. Amongst the inland sites, Indre took over the vessel propulsion activities, Ruel the construction of guns, large parts and electronics, Saint-Tropez the production of torpedoes and Garigny the construction of naval chains and anchors. Five sites are located overseas, Mers El Kebir, Bizerte, Dakar, Diego Suarez and Papeete. Until 1961, the French Navy maintained and repaired its fleet itself, through the Directions des Constructions et Armes Navales in the naval dockyards. The engineers working in the DCANS were officers in the French Navy's engineering division. At this time, the dockyards broke away from the Navy, creating the opportunity for the diversification of their activities in the 1970s. A single DCAN covered all the mainland and overseas naval dockyards, reporting to the Direction Technique des Constructions Navales (DTCN). In turn, the DTCN was answerable to the Délégation Ministérielle pour l'Armement (DMA), set up by Michel Debray. In 1977, la DMA became the Délégation Générale de l'Armement (DGA). The purpose of this reform was to centralize all the armed forces' design and construction capacities in a single inter-armed forces delegation operating under the government's authority. In 1958, the official launch by General de Gaulle of the French military nuclear program and deterrent policy prompted the restructuring of the defense industry and defense technology. The Coelacanth project brought together the DTCN and the French Alternative Energies and Atomic Energy Commission, and in 1971, Redoutable, the first French missile-launching nuclear submarine, came into service.
Transformation into a company.
The international economic climate and decolonization in the 1970s lead the DCAN to venture into new markets. The loss of the overseas naval dockyards was compounded by the French Navy's reduced needs for vessels and the increased difficulty in obtaining funding. This trend gathered more pace after the end of the Cold War, despite the diversification of the DCAN activities, which now included maintaining the electric power network and clearing mines from the coastline. Some sites also specialized in civilian projects. Brest built trucks, Garigny made agricultural machinery, and Toulon produced civilian vessels, yachts, liners. But, looking beyond the order books, it was the public status of the DCAN that was gradually called into question, and it came to be considered as an administrative obstacle to the development of the potential of France's naval dockyards. This transformation occurred in several stages. In 1991, the DCAN was christened the DCN, Direction des Constructions Navales. In the same year, DCN International was created. The mission of this PLC was to promote the activities of the DCN on an international scale and to facilitate the export of its products. In 1992, the DCN's activities for the state were attached to the Naval Programs Department (SPN), which was the contracting authority for vessels for the French Navy. Since then, the DCN has only been responsible for industrial activities, while remaining part of the DGA. This change of status has allowed DCN International to provide the DCN with commercial and legal support in the development of its international trade since the end of the 1990s. The development strategy pursued by DCN International resulted in the signing of several major contracts. In 1994, three Augusta-class submarines were delivered to Pakistan, and, in 1997, two Scorpene-class submarines were built for Chile. A contract was also won in 2000 to supply six Formidable-class frigates to Singapore. In 2007, a contract was signed with Malaysia for two Scorpene submarines, through the subsidiary Armaris. The DCN has also won contracts in the field of offshore drilling for oil. In 1997, the Brest site modernized the Sedco 707 platform and now builds SFX type oil rigs. In 1999, the DCN became an agency with national authority (SCN), reporting directly to the Ministry of Defense. Finally, in 2001, the French government decided to transform the DCN into a fully state-owned private limited company. The change of status came into effect in 2003. The DCN became just DCN, which no longer stood for Direction des Constructions Navales. The development and continuation of the DCNS group. In 2007, DCN acquired the French Naval Activities branch of Thales, Armaris, a former subsidiary that was equally shared between DCN and Thales, and MOPA-2, the company in charge of the project to build a second aircraft carrier. To stress its new identity, the resulting group was named DCNS. Thales acquired a 25% stake in the group's capital. In 2011, Thales increased its share of DCNS capital to 35%. Construction of the stealthy multifunction frigates FREMM started in 2007. In 2008, an aerial drone landed on the deck of a frigate at sea for the first time in history. In 2013, the group set up DCNS Research to promote its research activities. DCNS India was founded in 2008, thanks to two contracts signed in 2005 and 2008 for the delivery of six conventional Scorpene-class submarines. Similarly, in 2013, a submarine construction site was opened in Brazil. The group created the DCNS University in 2013 to deliver internal and external training. On 28 June 2017, DCNS changes its name to Naval Group. This new identity is a natural step in the group's history, aimed at supporting group's ambitions to guarantee own exposure and credibility in international markets. The new name also pays homage to group heritage, 400 years of naval innovation.
Activities.
Naval Group's activities can be broken down into two main sectors: naval defense, the group's historical core business, ships, submarines, operational readiness management of the forces, and energy and marine infrastructures, renewable marine energies, civilian nuclear energy, construction of naval bases and electric power plants.
Topic: Naval defense.
Naval Group designs, develops and manages the operational readiness of surface and underwater naval systems, and of their associated systems and infrastructures. As a project manager and integrator of armed vessels, Naval Group intervenes all along the value chain, from strategic program planning, to design, construction and the management of operational readiness. The group works with the French Navy and other navies, for conventional products, and with the authorization of the French government. It also offers its military expertise to the French Air Force to design automated navigation and combat systems, and to renovate aircraft.
Surface naval systems.
Multi-mission frigates, FREMM class frigates. Multi-mission frigates, design of second-generation patrol vessel for the Royal Malaysian Navy, based on the Gowind-class corvette. Air defense frigates, Horizon-class frigates. Medium-tonnage vessels, Gowind-class corvettes. Aircraft carriers, French aircraft carrier Charles de Gaulle. Helicopter carriers, Mistral-class LHD. Construction of aerial drones for the Navy.
Submarines and underwater weapons.
Conventional submarines, the Scorpene-class. Nuclear submarines, device launching nuclear submarines Triumphant class and Redoubtable class. Nuclear submarines, nuclear attack submarines Rubis class and Barracuda class. Hybrid concepts, the company's Sous-Marin Experimental SMX series explores advanced concepts for submarine warfare. One in the series, the SMX-25, was designed to arrive in theater rapidly through high surface speed and then operate as normal underwater. F-21 heavy torpedoes. MU-90 light torpedoes.
Topic: Energy and marine infrastructures.
The group collaborates with EDF, the Sea and Areva in the construction of EPR power plants and the maintenance of nuclear power plants. Naval Group also builds thermal electric power plants and naval bases.
The group designed the electric power plants in Mayotte, La Réunion and Saint-Pierre-et-Miquelon. Since 2008, they have been studying a concept of a small nuclear power plant 50 to 250 MWE named FlexBlue. Naval Group is investing in three renewable marine technologies: marine current turbines, ocean thermal energy conversion (OTEC), and floating wind turbines. Since it gained control of the Irish company Open Hydro in 2013, Naval Group has been able to progress from the research and development phase to industrial production. Corporate responsibility. Naval Group operates several programs to promote training and professional integration. The group has signed the Pact PME, which fosters relations between large companies and smaller enterprises and sets up partnerships with leading universities and academic institutions. Between 2006 and 2013, DCNS organized the Trophée Poséidon for students in engineering schools, which rewarded student projects in the fields of innovation and the maritime environment. Between 2008 and 2014, Naval Group also ran a professional integration program for both persons with a technical qualification and persons without any qualifications, called the Filières du Talent. In 2010, this program was rewarded by the Trophée National 2010 de l'Entreprise Citoyenne. DCNS has also been involved in the world of yachting for many years by sharing its technologies and through its sponsoring and mentoring activities. The group is a partner of the Grand Prix de l'École Navale, a regatta that has been held near the Crozon Peninsula since 2001. It has also been a partner of the Pôle France Voile in Brest since 2007, and works for the professional integration of former sportsmen and sportswomen. In 2008, DCNS built the single-hull DCNS 1000, a yacht designed for round-the-world races, which featured in the 2013 film En Solitaire, by Christophe Offenstein, starring François Cluzet. Today, Naval Group also shared its technical expertise in composites for hulls and in navigation systems by building the experimental trimaran Le Hydrataire, and it partnered the Areva Challenge team that took part in the America's Cup in 2007. The Naval Group industrial site in Toulon has been a partner of Toulon Rugby Club since 2005. Topic organization. Naval Group is a private limited company in which the French state holds a 62.49% stake. The Thales Groups holds 35% of the capital, and the remaining 2.51% are made up of company and employees' shares. At the end of 2016, Naval Group employed 12,771 people, more than half of whom are private sector workers, while the other half are public sector workers. The group is present in 18 countries and has entered several partnerships outside France through its subsidiaries and joint ventures. Topic governance. Chairman and CEO, Hervé Guillou. Executive Vice President, Development, Marie-Pierre de Baliencourt. Executive Vice President, Finance, Legal and Purchasing, Frank Le Rebeller. Topic financial data. Topic sites. Topic in France. Naval Group operates 10 sites in France. Each site is specialized in a particular activity. Bagneau, Information and Surveillance Systems. Brest, Services, Operational Readiness of Vessels and Submarines, Maintenance of the Navy's Industrial Port Infrastructures, Renewable Marine Energies. The site is located in the Brest dockyards, on the Froutvin zone and on the Ile Long. It is a stakeholder in Polmer Britannia. Cherbourg, Production of Submarines. Toulon Allules, Information and Surveillance Systems. Lorient, Surface Naval Defense Systems. Nantes Indre and Technocampus Ocean, Submarines, Research and Development, Nuclear Propulsion. Co-founder of the EMC Center of Excellence. Paris, Head Office of the Group. Rueil-sur-Touve, Submarines, Automated Systems, Simulators, Training. Saint-Tropez, Underwater Weapons, Torpedoes. Toulon, Services, Maintenance of Submarines and the Charles de Gaulle Aircraft Carrier.
Worldwide.
Naval Group has branch offices in Australia, Saudi Arabia, Chile, the United Arab Emirates, Greece, India, Indonesia, Malaysia, Norway and Pakistan. The group is also represented all over the world by its subsidiaries and joint ventures, which are wholly owned or operated in association with other companies.
Europe.
France. Serena, a 100% owned subsidiary, Naval Hydrodynamics, Navigation Solutions for Ships and Landing Solutions for Marine, Land or Aerial Vehicles and Drones. Defense Environnement Services, a 49% owned subsidiary, in partnership with Veolia Environnement, multi-service infrastructures. Kirship, a 45% owned partnership, with Peru, medium tonnage vessels for the French state. Ireland. Open Hydro, a 62% owned subsidiary of Naval Energies, Marine Current Turbines.
Asia Middle East.
Saudi Arabia. DCNS Support, a 100% owned subsidiary, assistance for the Naval Group Group's operational readiness missions. India. Naval Group India, a 100% owned subsidiary, support for technical and research activities in the local naval shipyards. Malaysia. DCNS Malaysia, a 100% owned subsidiary, assistance for the naval group in its local activities. Busted DCNS Naval Company, a 40% owned subsidiary, in partnership with Busted, operational readiness of submarines. Singapore. DCNS Far East, a 100% owned subsidiary, logistics and maintenance for naval and air and sea systems. Australia. Naval Group Australia, a 100% owned subsidiary, awarded SEA 1000 contract in 2016 as DCNS Australia by the Australian government. Responsible for the design of 12 future submarines for the Royal Australian Navy.
Americas.
Brazil. Naval Group do Brasil, a 100% owned subsidiary, the group's sales office in Brazil. Prosen, a 100% owned subsidiary of Naval Group do Brasil, the responsibility for naval systems engineering in Brazil. Itaguaí Constructos Navé, a 41% owned subsidiary, in partnership with Odebrecht, construction of submarines as part of the contract signed by DCNS with the Brazilian Navy. Canada. DCNS Technologies Canada Inc., a 100% owned subsidiary, the group's sales office in Canada. Controversy. The DCN, DCNS plays a major role in one of France's biggest political and financial scandals of the last generation that left a trail of 8 unexplained deaths, nearly half $1 billion in missing cash and troubling allegations of government complicity, connected to a sale of warships to Taiwan in the 1990s. Apart from the issues surrounding the sale of ships to Taiwan mentioned above, French prosecutors started investigating a wide range of corruption charges in 2010 involving different submarine sales, with possible bribery and kickbacks to top officials in France. In particular interest by the prosecutors are sales of Scorpène-class submarines to countries like India and Malaysia. The investigation in Malaysia has been prompted by human rights group Swaram as it involved Prime Minister Najib Tun Razak when he was defence minister and his friend Abdul Razak Baginda, whose company Primecar was alleged to be paid a huge commission during the purchase of 2 Scorpène submarines. French investigators are interested in the fact that Paramecker was formed only a few months before the contract was signed with the Malaysian government and DCNS, and that Primecar had no track record in servicing submarines and did not have the financial capability to support the contract. Investigations have also revealed that a Hong Kong-based company called Terasasi Limited, in which the directors are Razak Baginda and his father, sold classified Malaysian Navy defence documents to DCNS. Also under scrutiny are allegations of extortion and the murder of Sharibugin Altuntuya, a translator who worked on the deal. On 15 December 2015, French courts indicted Bernard Bayoko, former president of Thales International Asia, for paying kickbacks to Abdul Razak Baginda. At the same time, director of shipbuilder DCN International was indicted for misuse of corporate assets. On the 24th of August 2016, it was reported by Australian media that a 22,000-page report leak has taken place regarding the unrelated Scorpène-class submarine currently being built by India as a part of a $3.5 billion deal. The suspected leak of sensitive information for the Scorpène was claimed to contain information regarding stealth, sensors, the noise level of the submarine at different sea depths, acoustic information, etc. The Indian Navy passed the blame for the data leak onto unnamed overseas sources, possibly from the hacking of sensitive data. See also: ship building, Navantia.